Welcome to Barnstorming. Today I have with me... Please sing now.
Who?
You.
I don't know who I am. I have been so confused by this day. You know, Mexicans driving me here, Mexicans escorting me into the building, and Koreans all around the place. I can't even read the addresses there in Korean.
Well, it is.
While I'm fearful of being bombed by Korea, you know. So it's a terribly consternated world that I live in.
I really hadn't thought of that while I drive here, because we are in Koreatown. The person who drove you here got in another accident as you were
getting
here.
Well, she didn't get into it. The accident came to her.
The accident came to her.
Yeah.
And I'm always saying...
Almost killed my Mexican friend, Nick.
But I'm always saying we're in Koreatown, so you have to be careful, because they really don't... You know, drive. You have to be careful.
Oh, I know.
You know, they don't drive the same way we do.
Well, that woman pushing the stroller, I mean, I was amazed she could get up.
Why?
After we hit her. What's the matter?
They're very agile.
Oh, yeah.
Because they're lower to the ground,
Blimey.
So you don't do as much damage.
They have a very good center of gravity.
I don't think we're going to be invited back here.
Who? Where? Where? Oh, you mean the Koreatown?
The Koreatown.
Oh, okay.
I
was in the Korean War.
You were a chef.
No, I wasn't.
I read that you were a typist in France.
That's right.
Yeah, well, how was that the Korean War?
Well, the war was going on. What do you want? You wanted me to bring it to France or what?
But it wasn't in France. It was in Korea.
What, the Korean War?
Yeah, wasn't
it? It was all over the world. Are you crazy? A tremendous war. We left so many prisoners there, I'm telling you. I think the dictator of Korea is just an American deserter. I'm serious. Doesn't he look like the kid down the block?
Down this block, where we are now.
Yeah.
Not in my block.
No.
Or your block.
Oh, your block is cute.
I live in Glendale, Armenians.
You live in Glendale?
Yeah, Armenians and Chinese. We don't have any Koreans.
Yeah, they all sneak over here.
Eventually.
Yeah.
There used to be Nazis.
Nazis?
In Glendale.
In Glendale, yeah. Glendale's famous for Nazis.
Yeah, they were.
I never knew any Nazis in Glendale, but I'm willing to believe what I read.
Well, yeah, because the U.S. sent them over there, and Glendale High School had a bronze statue that they made them. They was there until the 50s of Goering or Herring or something. Not Herring, but you know what I mean.
Herring?
Like that.
It was silvery, wasn't it?
Well, yeah, because, and where my post office box is, there's a lot of really old Germans there, like 90.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
Mm-hmm.
That's old?
Oh, that's funny.
That voice came from Nick. Nick, we haven't even said your name, but you'd have to live in a cave if you don't know who we're talking to, if you don't recognize his voice. Mr. Ed Asner.
How do you do? All right. On
Lashana
November Tova. 15th.
Lashana Tova.
Thank you. Thank you.
Yes. Yes.
And the same to you, sister. November 15th, I'm going to be 88.
I know.
Yeah.
And that's...
Are you planning something to give me? I'll tell you what. I'll give you a few suggestions. And that's the casting couch over there?
Yeah. But that's...
Okay. We don't even have to leave this room.
Well, we have to have everybody else leave.
Yeah.
And it's not your birthday.
Oh, I don't care if they watch.
No, it's not your
birthday.
They
can learn a lot, believe me.
It's not your birthday yet. Do I have to do it before?
Goddamn dummies.
Well, that's another thing. I mean, I guess you didn't experience that a lot, but that reminds me of sexual harassment. Not that what you're saying
me?
Now. No. But it's just that, it's just that in my day, which is still my day, but people say things, and I mean...
Would you like a quaalude?
Well, no. Did you ever try a quaalude? Did you ever get a quaalude?
No.
Okay, I never
say
did
it, right,
either.
Right. Would you like a quaalude?
I'm not a racist.
Here we're hearing. Nick, would you... Nick,
hi,
Nick, what is your
Nick,
last name?
Nick Granato.
Nick Granato.
He's not important. Ignore
him. He works
him.
With Mr. Asner, right? He's one of no, his dear friends.
No, he doesn't work with, don't give me that crap. Works for his dad, my ass.
Well, you must pay
He's
him for something.
He's a pain in the ass.
No, but, you know, sexual harassment. I mean, I would think, wow, I mean, if you're not
I always
harassed,
like to pronounce it as sexual harassment.
Oh, sexual harassment.
Yeah.
And I'm saying
I like that stress on ass, you know? It means something.
Yeah, when I sat in your lap earlier, you said I had a nice ass. And I didn't really know I even had one. I mean, I have to work really hard. I don't have a Kardashian butt.
Did you notice mine?
No. No, do you have a butt? You probably don't because you're Jewish.
No.
Jews
what?
Don't.
He's got nothing but back. All the way to
yeah,
his knees.
It's back and a crack. Not all Jews, but a lot. I mean, you're Russian Jewish, right?
It holds a lot of caca, I'll tell you that.
I'm sorry to hear that. I mean,
yeah. Well, we store it up, and then at the right season, we let it out. We use it to grow things.
Vegetables. Mm-hmm. It makes it really big.
Yeah. Good.
Well, I when I dated a Jew, I mean, I love Jewish men. That's pretty much all I
They're good lovers, aren't they? Huh?
No, not always.
Oh, fuck you. What do you know?
Well,
you
rich,
don't know shit.
Well, you know, rich ones aren't.
Huh? What?
Rich Jews aren't good lovers, but poor Jews are good.
If anybody knows that Jewish men are good lovers, it's Ed.
Well,
that's Nick.
I'm on very short rations right now. Yeah. I haven't been laid for a number of, we'll say.
I'm sure it's by choice.
No, well, it's because I don't put myself out.
You know, you look really good.
Yeah?
Yeah, because I was doing a lot of research on you, and I think the last thing I saw this morning when you, it was old, it was like maybe, was it 2011 or 2009, you were talking to Screen Actors Guild because you were against the merger with AFTRA.
Yeah.
And you were just.
That farce.
I know. But you look a lot better than you did in that
YouTube. Really?
Yeah.
I guess I was under stress from the union at the time.
Yeah. And you know, do you ever look back? Because this is what I was thinking about as I was doing all the
research. I promise not to tell.
On the research on you, that, you know, you got so much flack, right? When you were in the second term of, you know, our president. I mean, all the Emmys, or, you know, LeBron was in the top 10.
No, it wasn't.
At the time, it wasn't in the top 10?
No.
What was it?
But it was an important show.
It was an important show. So, and you got a lot of flack when you supported the Contras, right?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. No, not the cow. No. Go back and reread.
The Sandinistas.
Jesus Christ.
The Sandinistas.
Elliot. No. What the hell?
Who is
Abrams?
Who's Elliot Abrams?
Who was that?
You supported medical aid for El Salvador.
Yeah,
you went to Washington. You raised $25,000, which I think was your own money, right? Yeah.
No.
Or you at least you raised it, and you was a very, you know, because you were shining a light on that.
Yeah.
Right. And
about how our government, how unusual that our government was lying to us. It's so unusual, you know. It's amazing how we were able to talk about government lying.
Well, do you think that we talked a lot about government? I know we do now, but do you think we talked a lot about government lying then?
Oh, no.
I mean, I didn't.
No. Everybody was raising their arms in Sieg Heil salutes to government in those days. Our great government.
Well, I just was thinking that you took such a beating on that press-wise, and I think it's because you were so, for so many years, you were known as, right, the gruff, but, you know, the soft
lovable
guy,
lovable,
Pillsbury dope, you know, lovable, misunderstood, but loves everybody. Yeah. And I don't think that they were ready for that. Like, if you had been, like, a New York liberal Jew, say if you've been Alan Alda or Elliot Gould, anybody else that people
Alan Alda wouldn't put himself out.
I agree.
Yeah.
But I'm saying if it was, I'm just using this as an example.
Uh-huh.
I think that people would have gone, but they would have expected it. They wouldn't have agreed, but they wouldn't have expected it, and they would have been kind of careful to say anything because I think they wouldn't want to be seen as anti-Semitic, right?
Mm-hmm.
And you did, and nobody knew that you had those views. So I think they came down harder on you because you were seen as this, as you know, Kansas City, Kansas, Middle America, right?
I hate to get serious. Well, I come from Kansas.
Kansas City, Kansas. Mm-hmm. And your parents were junk dealers.
Yep.
And your mother would wash the bottles.
Father. My mother didn't deal junk.
No, but she would wash the bottles, you said.
Yeah. You know all that.
No, well, I do know that. How many? Did you have all sisters? You were the youngest.
Two sisters.
Okay. And what was the thing? I know you were the baby, but how'd it go? Brother, sister, brother, sister?
Brother, sister, sister, brother.
They say that a man is the best marriage a candidate when he's the baby and is raised by older sisters.
Really?
Yes.
Well, they help.
So I know you've had a few.
Both my older sisters died in 14.
2014?
Yeah.
Of what?
Well, old age.
Oh, just
one
old
was
age.
95 and one was 98. And I sure loved them. They were a couple of characters.
Well, who was the one that told you, I love this story, that when you were in high school, there was a guy by the name of Boner something?
What was his name? Not when I was in high school. When I was...
In college?
Even before school. When I was in, before public school.
Oh, before public school? So you were that little? Like you were like like 4 or 5?
Yeah.
Oh, I thought you were more like middle school or high school. Okay.
No.
And his name was Boner Salvadoro?
Lombreno. Yeah.
And he would beat you up or try make fun
of
you, bully you?
Well, he did that one night, and I went upstairs. My sister was there with an uncle, and I was crying, and Boner beat me up. And she said, well, did you hit him? And I said, no. She said, well, you go down there, and you hit him. So I went down there again to hit him, and he beat the shit out of me again.
That's why I love this story. You know, I hate movies with happy endings. I love this story.
That explains a lot about the way you treat me.
You know, because you would think, oh, yeah, something changed there. But, you know.
I try to relive Boner through him. Yeah. Boner served, I think, in action in Korea while I was typing in France.
Oh, I thought you were going to say he was doing something while you were like a huge movie star, television movie star, Golden Globe.
He came back and he wasn't too healthy and I guess he died prematurely. But when I told that story, I don't know where it was printed, and one of his sisters or cousins wrote and said, how dare you talk about Boner that way? It was not nice. And I was... just honoring him. That's all I was
doing.
You're
just being honest. You didn't say anything.
He was one of my best friends. Tony Lopez was my other one.
Oh.
And Nikki Sindrich was beating the shit out of me at that point. And Tony, like a wise old friend, said, you got to stand up to him. You got to stand up to him. I said, okay. Okay. So the next time Nikki picked on me, I stood up to him. And he backed off. I said, my God, I felt that sense of power, you know. I made him back off. He didn't come at me. So then a little time passed. And then as time passed, that effect began to wear off on Nikki. And he started to get surly and stick his nose into my life again. And fortunately, we moved from the neighborhood. Because I don't think I could have stood up against him twice.
That was in the Bottoms, right?
In the Bottoms, the West Bottoms.
Yeah, I'd never heard that before.
Yeah.
Yeah. And then when you went to University of Chicago, right, mm-hmm. you said that you were okay, but you would when your grades slipped, right, you went back home and because your parents wouldn't pay for college anymore, right, because your grades...
Well,
right?
Actually, that wasn't the real reason.
Okay, what was it?
I mean, my grades were bad.
But you used to be an honor student. At least that's what one article said.
Oh, in high school.
Okay.
But I had gotten very tight with a non-Jewish girl.
Yeah.
And it caused the grades to slip. And finally, my dad saw that I wasn't going to cut it off immediately. And he cut off my funds immediately.
Oh, because she was a shiksa.
Uh-huh.
Really? Oh, my goodness. So what did you do? Did you go along with it and move back home, or did you keep staying?
Well, I had discovered theater at the same time. Right. The two went hand Is it hand?
In hand.
Or penis in hand?
We still say hand. Yeah.